Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the relations of both right and left kidneys, anterior as well as the posterior relations, okay? In previous video, we already learned about the location, shape, measurements or dimensions, and external features about the poles, surface, border, and the hilum, okay? I show you all that also. And this figure shows the location and how the right and left kidneys are arranged, okay? And this figure shows the how much distance is the poles, hilum, and upper and lower poles and the hilum, how much distant from the median plane. And also this figure shows the measurements of the measurements as well as external features of the kidney. And this figure shows the and what are the structures that entering and exiting the hilum from anterior to posterior. Okay, coming to the topic, relations of kidney, okay? Relations, anterior relations. The anterior relations of two kidneys are different, okay? Anterior relations of two kidneys are different because and the structures that present front of the each kidney is different, okay? First, about anterior surface of right kidney. Right suprarenal gland, right lobe of the liver, second part of duodenum, hepatic flexure, jejunum. These are the structures that present anterior to the right kidney. Once again, right suprarenal gland. Try to remember, guys, by closing eyes. Right suprarenal gland, right lobe of liver, second part of duodenum, hepatic flexure, and jejunum, okay? Out of this, liver and jejunum are separated from the kidney by peritoneum. Once again, out of this, liver as well as jejunum are separated from kidney by peritoneum. The peritoneum separates kidney from liver as well as jejunum. Coming to the figure, suprarenal area, suprarenal gland, right lobe of liver. This shows the second part of duodenum, right colic flexure, hepatic flexure. Okay, this is the jejunum. Okay. And here gives by area, that means suprarenal area, hepatic area, duodenal area, colic area, jejunal area. Okay. Next, coming to the out of this, kidney is separated from liver and jejunum by peritoneum. Next, anterior surface of left kidney. Left suprarenal gland, spleen, stomach, pancreas, and splenic vessels, left colic flexure, jejunum. These are the structures that present anterior to the left kidney. You may easily remember these points, that is left suprarenal gland about stomach as well as pancreas, and the we already learned about the colic fluctuation, but it is right there, that is right here, it is left, and there that is right, and jejunum. Okay, out of these, stomach, spleen, jejunum are separated from the kidney by peritoneum. Jejunum is same as there, and the other ones are stomach as well as spleen. What is the other one there? Liver. In liver, here it is replaced by stomach as well as spleen. Okay, coming to the figure. Left suprarenal gland. This is for stomach. This is the spleen. This is the area for pancreas. This is the left colic flexure. And this is the jejunum. Okay. Once again, try to remember by closing eyes. Left suprarenal area. Stomach. Splenic vessels, pancreas, left colic area, and jejunum. These are the structures. Out of these, spleen, stomach, and jejunum are separated from the left kidney by peritoneum. Okay, I think it is clear. Coming to posterior relations. Okay, posterior relations of two kidneys are the same. Okay, posterior relations of two kidneys are the same, except that right kidney is related to one rib while left kidney is related to two ribs. Okay, right by one, left by two. Okay, have you remember guys this right one and left two? How? You may keep your code left two. Okay, next coming to the structures or relations of kidneys. First, four muscles. Okay, one diaphragm, quadratus lumborum, psoas major, transversus abdominis. What are the four muscles? Diaphragm, quadratus lumborum, psoas major, transversus abdominis. Okay, it is easy for you to remember the diaphragm and transversus abdominis. Okay, because these structures are present in abdomen, and the diaphragm may be in related with it. Okay, quadratus lumborum and other next one is the psoas major. I think it is easy to you. Once again, dapt, you may remember it like dapt. Okay, Q is seen just like a small a. Okay, diaphragm, D diaphragm, A quadratus, that means four quadratus lumborum, psoas major, P psoas major, and T transversus abdomen. Okay, next three nerves: subcostal, iliohypogastric, iliolingual. The subcostal nerve is accompanied by subcostal vessels. What are the three nerves? T12, L1. In L1, two are them: iliohypogastric, iliolingual. Hypogastric means that is below the stomach. Okay, subcostal, T12, iliohypogastric, ileum, ingual. Okay, The subcostal nerve is accompanied by subcostal vessels. One are two ribs. The right kidney is related to the 12th rib. And the left kidney is related to the 11 and 12 ribs. Okay, once again, right means correct. One person marries one. That like here is only one rib, that is 12th rib. Left means that is wrong. You may remember like that. This wrong person marries two. That is 11 and 12. Okay. Right one have only one. Wrong one have, that is left have two. Once again, four muscles are there. Remember that is daft. D, diaphragm. A, quadratus lumborum. And psoas major. And T, transversus abdominis. What are the three nerves? That is T12 and L1 in 2. 1, subcostal. And next L1 has 2, that is below stomach. Ilio, hypogastric and ilio inguinal. And subcostal nerve is accompanied by subcostal vessels. One are two ribs. One, the right person marries one, that is T12, and left person marries two, that is 11th and 12th. Okay, right is correct. First, coming to the figure, this figure shows this left kidney is related with two ribs, 12th and 11th, and it is at diaphragm, subcostal vessels and nerves. These are the subcostal vessels and nerves, and this is at transverse abdominis, iliohypogastric, and this is the iliohypogastric nerve. This is the transverse abdominis, iliohypogastric nerve, ilioinguinal nerve. This is the psoas major is present, psoas major, and this is the quadratus lumborum. This is the quadratus lumborum, and the other structures are median, arcuate ligament, lateral arcuate ligament, subcostal vessels and nerves of right kidney, transverse abdominis, iliohypogastric nerve, ilioinguinal nerve. Okay, practice this diagram, guys. Okay, that makes you easy to remember the relations of both the kidneys of posterior. Inguinal ligament is more lower than the stomach, and abdomen is more abdomen. You may keep some other code to remember this, even this diagram also. That's your choice. Okay. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.